The recent global technology outage caused by CrowdStrike highlights again the resilience that people, companies and government have placed on connected devices. It's a world that's totally connected where data's king and security is of the utmost importance. Kyndryl was spun out of American computer giant IBM in 2021 and provides technology infrastructure to Aussie clients like Mitsubishi, Macquarie University and Ausgrid. Ross Greenwood caught up with the CEO of Kyndryl, Martin Schroeter, a little earlier to understand what we can learn from the CrowdStrike disaster.
When we were spun out of IBM, and today as well, we have very much a run and transform approach. So we run mission critical systems around the world, like we do here in Australia, banking, financial services, insurance, government. And the very nature of technology says that as innovation comes in, you need, for mission critical, you need to both run and transform. And that's where the challenge lies for all businesses. How do I take advantage of innovation while keep running what I'm already doing?
Okay, so let me ask you one question. It's okay for maybe younger people to get their heads around this, but a lot of boards of companies these days, if they've come from a legal background, from an accounting background, how do they understand the risks inside their business and or the opportunities that they may or may not be missing out on?
Yeah, look, it's a great question. Look, at the end of the day, the governance of corporations and their focus of let's say the last 20 years has really been on those two elements. What's the opportunity and where is that innovation showing up and how do we take advantage of that? What's the risk? Are we resilient? How do we know that our data is secure? And that governance structure has been really matured over the last few years, over the last few decades, I should say. And therefore, what we see, and for instance, you mentioned the CrowdStrike incidents earlier, not bad guys, right? It was an error.
Yeah.
But it took 45,000 servers down, but because of the innovation that we bring, we have full visibility to our infrastructure, we have full visibility to our customers, so we can get going right away. All of that maturity has been driven by investment and by, you know, good governance practices.
Okay, so Kyndryl in itself, you run big data centers in a lot of countries. I think there's more than 400 of them. So you play in that game, but you also advise companies to move, and I know Macquarie University here in Australia is one, where you've advised them to move onto the AWS system. So I'm kind of interested in that because you don't have complete control over that, but you're giving advice to businesses to help them to move onto such platforms.
Yeah, exactly right. So in the case of and Amazon is a place where there's a lot of innovation. Microsoft has a lot of innovation. Google brings a lot of innovation. So while we say, yes, we do run data centers, we run infrastructure. Whether your infrastructure sits in your own data center or your infrastructure sits in one of our data centers or it's on a public cloud, what companies need to be able to access is innovation, and they need a service provider like us to be able to help them keep it all running, make sure it's all efficient, make sure it's optimized. So yeah, we run across that hybrid infrastructure.
Okay, so explain to me what happened inside your business when the CrowdStrike incident occurred. Just exactly what happened, because you suddenly have every one of your clients ring you up saying, we've got a problem.
Many clients, but remember, it was very concentrated into Microsoft. So what happens is we see the blue screen of death like everybody else, right? But our monitoring tools and our visibility allows us to know very specifically what the server is and what it does. So within 12 hours, within 12 hours from the first time, and it was found here, by the way, right? Mm. Within 12 hours, we had all our mission critical systems up, working with our customers to prioritize them. And by the end of the weekend, everything was running again. So there was no automated fix for CrowdStrike. It was a sort of a rare event where it could not be automated. You needed physically to go reboot machines twice. So visibility tells us where we go. Observability tells us where to go, and then working with our clients, we can understand how they need to prioritize.
Okay, but then let's go to the malicious side of this,
yes,
which is, you know, where you've got hackers, you've got, you know, bad agents basically trying to come after,
yes,
systems and come after data for government, for defense, for individual companies. So the issue there, quite clearly, is that with artificial intelligence these days, their ability to adapt, their ability to innovate is just as great as the company's is, and so therefore trying to keep on top of that innovation is also,
yeah,
key to every company and to companies such as yours.
Yeah, so security is still a resiliency discussion as well. every company realizes that while we need to protect our customers' data, every government knows they need to protect their citizens' data, that has become really around how do I isolate? They're going, to your point, they are fast, they are innovative, they're going to get in, so you need to isolate them. But more, just as importantly, or maybe more importantly, once it's isolated and I can keep them in a little space, I need to make sure my business or my government process can still run, so the resiliency features still come right front of mind again.
So, Martin, the thing that we've observed here in Australia is that many of these data breaches, the big ones that we've seen in Australia, have been actually pretty basic, pretty simple individuals making mistakes about their own security.
Yeah, I would say more than 90% of breaches are still because somebody clicked on something untoward.
Totally.
Right. So for us, that a lot of that is about education. Right. We continuously educate our own Kyndryls. We continuously educate our customers. We test so that people know what the bad guys look like, and so education prevents a lot of that. And then secondly, you know, what's really important in addition to education, not only the resiliency features, but there are ways to make sure that it's isolated. Make sure you're architected in a way that even if somebody does something bad, you can isolate it very quickly.
Okay, so Martin, does it ever occur to you that the world is moving so fast, and especially in this space, that there are jobs that are disappearing as a result of it, but there are many, many more jobs that are being created, jobs that we haven't even thought about yet, are being created every single day, every single week. And it's just that not only are businesses innovating, are governments innovating, but individuals are having to innovate in the way in which they work.
Very true. And look, I'll give you one of our own Kyndryl examples. So we use AI throughout the platform that we deliver our services called Kyndryl Bridge. And Kyndryl Bridge allows us to automate a lot of processes to help deliver better service, to help keep our customers at industry best practice, to help patch things. I mean, it's just as simple as patching. And so what that allows us to do is allows us to take the people who were patching and re-educate, reskill, and put those people now at the forefront of innovation, at the things that are moving, but allow them to get Google Cloud skills or AWS Cloud skills. So yes, what technology, what innovation is, it's doing a couple things. It is allowing businesses to solve whatever challenge they have. It's providing tools for that. And it's allowing companies like us and others to free people up, to reskill them, to do other things and drive more value for the firm.
And so that's the idea, is it's innovation, it's efficiency, it's profitability. That's got to be the key to any form of investment in technology. Otherwise, why would a company do it?
Yeah, in enterprise tech, every investment has a business case to it, right? It's not like consumer tech, where I get a new phone because I like a new phone. Mm. In enterprise tech, everything has a business case. And the business cases have those characteristics, right? I need paybacks that suit whatever macro environment I'm in. I need things that support my overall strategy, and I need to support all the things I know are important, like it's still going to be secure, it's still going to be resilient, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But that is exactly how the business cases are done.
Martin Schroeter, I'll tell you what, great to have you on the program, Chief Executive of Kyndryl. Great to chat to you.
Thank you, Ross.